guys, Jatin here. Welcome all to the paddleboat tutorial of Sketchup, in which we demonstrate how to make a paddleboat on Sketchup. The paddleboat is going to be rubber band powered and it's going to be completely 3D printed, so the designing needs to be done first, and that's what we're going to do right now. So first of all, we need to free up the Sketchup environment for our use, and for that we're going to use the eraser tool and delete the 3D printer wireframe right here. Now, we are going to first start by making the hull of the paddleboat. The paddleboat is going to be made in two parts. The first part is going to be the hull, and the second part is going to be the paddle. Also, there are going to be these small two rods that go inside the hole in the paddleboat to hold the paddle. But we are going to make those later. First, we'll focus on the hull. For that, we're going to first start by making the rectangle of size 120,75. So 120 is the length, 75 is the breadth. Now we are going to create the front streamlined portion of the boat, because the boat needs to cut the water efficiently to move through the water. So that's what we are going to make the front portion of the boat. So now that is going to be made by the 3-point arc tool. Now the 3-point arc tool needs three specific reference points to make the arc clearly, and for that we are going to use the tape measure tool and create two lines on which we locate our reference point for the arc. So for the first line, we are going to take a distance of 45 mm, and the other line will take straight up half, 22.5 mm. Now we're going to sketch a line from the intersection point of one of the guidelines and stretch it till the midpoint of the front, and we're going to do the same on the other side. Now we have a triangular shape happening in front of the hull of the boat, and we're going to draw these two lines along the other guideline to the side edges of the paddleboat. Now this will give us all three reference points for the 3-point arc tool. What are those reference points? This end point right here, this midpoint right here, and this end point right here. This is going to be the three points through which our arc is going to pass. For that, we're going to click here, click on the second reference point, click on the third reference point, and there you go, our arc is now created. We're going to do the same on the other side and delete the stray lines like this, and like this. There we go. Now our hull is created. I'll push pull this hull up to a distance of 10 mm, so that this gives us a thickness of 1 cm from on the side of the boat. That's ideal, that's all we need. Now we move on to the center part of the boat. So from the top coming to the center, we'll be making a hole in which the paddle sits. So this hole obviously needs to be taken care of first, because we'll be making the paddle later, and the paddle needs to be made in a size which makes it compatible with the hole we are making right now. So that's why we're taking care of it first. We'll use a tape measure tool and create a profile for a rectangle, and then we'll make the rectangle later using the rectangle tool. So click on one edge, drag up to a distance of let's say 15 mm on either side of the paddleboard. On this side, we are going to take a distance of from this side 70 mm, seems fine, and 15 mm. So this here is going to be the profile of the rectangle for the whole of the paddle. So clicking here and dragging and push pulling this down, and there we are, our hole for the paddleboard is now ready. Looks fine. Alright, now we move on to the rear part of the boat where I think these sharp corners don't really look good and I need to create a chamfer here. So, or a fillet, let's say a fillet. So for a fillet, what we're going to do is we're going to use the tape measure tool and create a guideline which goes in say 5 mm on all the adjacent sides, the three adjacent sides. This gives us the two points on which the 2-point arc tool can be referenced. So these two points will be the points where we'll use a 2-point arc tool to create a fillet like this. Do the same on the other side, selecting the 2-point arc tool, click here, and we're done. Again, see this from the side, because now we're going to be push-pulling this, and to push-pull, click on the stray volume and drag down, and that's how we get our fillet. Like so. And that's the fillet done at the back. This gives us a very appealing shape for our paddle boat. Looks nice. Alright, now we are going to start on the fins at the bottom. These fins are really, really important because they give a direction to the paddle boat and they make sure that it follows the direction that it's pointing. And these will be created by using the rectangle tool again. I'll demonstrate it right now. So we'll first start by giving a profile to the rectangle. And we'll do this again with the tape measure tool. Just as we created the hole here, right here, we'll be making a profile for the rectangle using the tape measure tool, and then we'll use the rectangle tool and make it perfectly. Now, we first consider this edge and draw a guideline which goes in say 7 mm, and a guideline from here which goes 4 mm. That would be fine. Same from on this side, 4 mm and 7 mm. Make sure you don't take these guidelines from the points, since it sometimes what happens is it just gives us a guide point and not a line. So that's not what we require here. We require a complete guideline. So that's why we are taking the guide point from a line and not a point like here. Now, the profile of the rectangle is almost ready. The two opposite sides are done, but now we need to get the other two sides. For that, we're going to use this line here. Take a guideline, say 20 mm from this edge, and again using this edge, I'm going to take a guideline which is, I can see the length below. I'll be using a sensible dimension, say 65 looks right. I'll select 65, type 65 and press enter. And that's where our profile of the rectangle is ready. Click, and using the rectangle tool, I'll be now converting that temporary imaginary profile into the rectangle that we want, and delete the guidelines using the edit delete guides. That's there, our guidelines have now vanished. Now we'll be bringing these fins out using the push pull tool. Now keep a structure in mind, right? So I want a similar extrusion for both of these fins, right? So for the first fin, I'll be doing say a 7 mm extrusion. So I'll push pull this out 7 mm. And there's a nifty trick here. When I click on the second profile, I need not type 7 mm. I can just drag my mouse onto the surface or on the edge of the other fin. This tells Sketchup that we want this fin as a reference and it creates an extrusion that is similar to the fin that we push-pulled first. So that's how we make sure, without typing anything, that these two fins are now flush and are push-pulled the same amount. We click and we're done. Now, I would want these fins to have a pointy structure at the front and not be this blocky at the front, because a pointy structure would make sure that the water, it cuts through the fins, cut through the water easily, and there is minimal friction for the boat when traveling in the water. So for that, we are going to use the tape measure tool. Again, the tape measure tool is the best tool that we can have in SketchUp, since it gives us so much possibilities on how to model stuff. So again, go on any edge, click and drag, say 7 mm. So for the cut, I need 2 points, and I have those 2 points here and here. So I'll click and make the line like so. Again, I'll do that same thing there. And now I'll use the push-pull tool. And delete these extra volume that I have. And that's done there. So this is going to be the bottom part of our paddleboat done. Looks fine, we're progressing. Now we'll come to the paddle, and for the paddle we need arrangements for the pins on the side. For that, we are going to make the pins separately on the side of the paddleboat, and we are going to make holes on either side of the hole so that the pins can be inserted in the hole and we can have the arrangement for the paddle done. So now the holes need to be in the exact center of this hole here, because the paddle needs to be aligned straight in the middle of this hole. If the holes are not in the center and are slightly offset to the front or the back, the paddle is going to collide with the boat, and that's not what we want. You'll understand what I'm saying when I'll make the provision for the holes. So now, first of all, we need a reference point on the sides which is symmetrical, so that the holes are created in the same line, right? The holes should be in the same line as well. Why? Because the paddle needs to be mounted straight. If it's not straight, if it's tilted to the right or the left, the boat will not go straight. So you'll see when I make the holes right now. So first of all, what I'll do is I'll try making the reference point first. So from the midpoint, I'll take a reference point line, say 7 mm. And from the bottom, again, this line I'll take at the midpoint, because I want the center of the circles to lie in the midpoint of this line right here. And again, 7 mm. So these are the two midpoints for the circles. Click, and now we want our hole to be of radius 3 mm. So we'll write 3 mm here. 3 mm right here. And push pull these a distance of 7 mm. So 7 mm. This again, since I undoed it. So, now the holes are ready. As you can see, the pins are going to be made separately, and the radius is going to be smaller than 3 mm. The radius here is 3 mm. The radius of the pins has to be smaller than 3 mm, since it needs to go inside the hole. So for that, I'm going to create a circle, give a radius of 2.5 mm, and push pull this up 20 mm, right? So this is going to be our first pin. I need not make the second pin. I can just copy it. How? By selecting the whole assembly, using, and now I use the move tool. Select the move tool, press control. You see a plus pops right beside the icon of the move tool. That means we are right now in copy mode. We click and drag. That's how we can make copies. I'll show it to you again. Control, click and drag, and press. That's how you make very easily copies of any object in Sketchup. Now we move on to the paddle.